Now, at the time of filming this, it is exactly 1 week before Christmas, and we're back at the Grand Union Canal, at the point where River Brent, which comes down here, joins on to the Grand Union Canal that comes down there, and they both flow together for a little way down to the Thames. The canal sort of ducks on and off of the river. Whenever there needs to be a lock, the river will go off and round, and the canal will go down in a lock, but we will carry on down this way, down the combined canal and river. And today we should get onto the Thames and then a little way along the Thames as well. Very large building of some sort, just above the trees over there. Very long building. Not sure what that is. Hey, look, that looks like a proper boat. That's like what a kid would draw as a boat, isn't it?
It is.
With a proper anchor as well. This is the building I mentioned a minute ago. It seems to be a great big old warehouse that's been split up into a number of industrial units. That's huge. I guess it must have been a factory or something at some point. I have no idea what a pole driving competition is. It could be something to do with the edging of the canal. That one's going to require a bit of research, I think. Thank you. as this is now river and canal, navigable river, you've got to be a little more careful when mooring because water levels can change. So you have to moor up, accounting for the fact that the river level can go up or down, and you either risk having your boat dangling off the mooring, off the bollards if you've moored with ropes that are too short, or well, sinking if your river level goes up and you've moored with ropes that are too short. So here we have the first one along here, a weir where the river will diverge from the canal, and then over there you can just see there is going to be a lock just around the corner. So the river here, there you go, Ostley Park Weir. The river here goes over a rather nasty looking weir. You wouldn't want to get your boat caught in that, but you couldn't get under the bridge anyway. And so the river changes level abruptly on a weir to go down to the new level. And the boats take a much more leisurely change of level through the lock over there. All the crud that's floated down the river getting caught in the ends of the weir. I thought for a while that this lock gate was broken, but I think it's just drifted open where the water level's the same.
Yeah.
And then that water that went over the weir returns here beneath the lock. Rather chunky bridge. I'm not a fan of graffiti in general, but some of this is pretty good. Especially the Elmer Fudd. Looking down into the canal under here looks a little foreboding. Bridge 206A. It shows that the canals have been around for an awful lot of an awful lot longer than the railways have. This bridge belongs to London Underground Limited. This bridge up there belongs to London Underground. Although London Underground Limited is probably now TfL. Transport for London. I thought for a moment this was going to be a turnover bridge, but it's not. It's just a regular bridge where you'd have to have uncoupled the horse, go up over the bridge, and then recouple the horse on the other side. Horsley Ironworks near Birmingham, 1820. Another weir here, right next to a main road. And something else you don't see on the canals very often is CCTV. In this case, watching either down the canal or just watching the weir. I don't have my drone, that's a nice, that's a cool sloopy weir. Suddenly the far edge of the canal is a lot lower, so this looks like a high level spillway if the weir back there isn't managing to shed enough water out of the canal into the river down there, then any extra water will flow over these blocks here and go join the river before over flooding the top of the gates at this lock up here. It's also a handy perch for seagulls and other birds. There's a number of large companies based around here, around Brentford. You've got, through the trees on that side, the GlaxoSmithKline GSK offices, pharmaceutical giant. And on this side, you may just be able to see through the trees those coloured lines. That's the Sky Campus, where a whole load of Sky offices and their head office in the UK is. Play competition of name that knot, but my knots aren't very good, despite having been a Boy Scout. Quite a nice little riverside bit for GSK here. You've got art up there, you've got a little water feature over here, presumably just pumping water out of the canal and back in again. This would be a nice one to come past at night when its lights are on. This one also appears to have a Big Ben on the roof, or on the far side. It's a floating dog hotel, apparently. Well, there you go. You see something new every day. Ooh, a fence. While filming this, I've just looked up and noticed that what I thought was dilapidated old wooden structure is actually deliberately more or less like that. It's got flower and leaf patterns on it. I mean, the peeling is not part of the art, but the patterns are nice. Although the roof could do with a little bit of work. This, I assume, at one point would have been for loading and unloading barges into warehouses. The river goes off down that direction again, and the canal carries on this way through Brentford Basin to the second to last lock on the Grand Union Canal. Going to pronounce this wrong, but I'm guessing that one over there, Hoop op Velvaart, is probably Dutch, seeing as it is a Dutch barge. Ooh, another fuel boat. There's some water goes off. Oh, there's a weir there, without any fence across it. So that's the river goes off that way. A little basin here is kind of cool. And a couple of locks with... Ooh, these are manned locks. You've got the control cabin here. And massive, great big paddle level indicators. And then pneumatically controlled gates. So the lock keeper would be in his little office over there. is Brentford Gauging Lock 100. So this appears to be the end of the canal, and you're getting pretty close to being on the tidal Thames by this point. I'm not entirely sure where the towpath goes here. We're going to have to do a bit of investigation. It's not this side, it carries on that side. This suddenly got a lot more industrial feeling. Although these poles with the balls on top are a little reminiscent of Venice, but not really the rest of it. Built themselves a deck. Oh, maybe they get given a deck on these moorings. Any weed? If you want any water weed, this is the place to come and get it. Any pond weed? This boat's a bit grand, isn't it? This one's built around its mooring. That's oddly amusing. This is apparently the footpath. No exit ahead. Up over the flood wall. This is certainly different.
Yeah. Really cold.
It's looking a little bit, these ones, I'm not sure these are actually floating. I think the ones this side are just sort of sat on the mud. Choice to make now. Do we see what's up over there, or do we go that way? I'm going up over here. That looks like it should be private, and this looks like it should be part of the footpath. I have a sneaking suspicion that that would have been a dock at some point in time where boats would have gone into this warehouse to unload, but it's since been built across the front with this bridge to allow the towpath to carry on along here. Being pushed away from the canal again. So we'll go try and find it again. Oh, we're going under a high bridge. Oh, yes we are. I thought there was a gate. There's a footpath next to it. Well, this is an adventure. Hello, river again. Back up over the flood defences. into a wharf. A bit, this is the towpath that's a bit in advance of itself. I understand through there, but we go around and back down here. It does look like there used to be some path going that way, but there's definitely not now. And we make it back onto the canal side again. I like that. That about sums it up, actually. Along the towpath, the Sunday walkers ramble, overtaken by lycra joggers and cyclists. Ooh, steamboat. Unfortunately, going away from us. I think this lock up here is the last lock on the Grand Union Canal. This is Thames Lock, but it appears to just be open. I'm guessing that this one only has to be closed and open either during certain tide times or possibly even only when there's a particularly high tide. On the far side of the lock over there appears to be what was once a boat, which is now plonked on dry land with a boat on its roof. We can't get much further going that way. What is that on that barge? Is that a bit of bridge? Or a bit of canal, I suppose. Yeah. I just looked down. That's lovely and clean. Gotta love the Thames. Let's go up here. dry dock here. It appears they raise and lower that entire tank to bring it up out of the water to work on whatever's in it. Which is kind of impressive. I think we want to be over there, but I'm not sure quite how to get to it at the moment. Ooh, route master buses. We did make it over here, we just had to go around the building site to get to it. Oh, that is the tiniest little narrowboat I've ever seen.
That's my size, that is.
Tiny little mallard. This here appears to be a barge with a piece of road on top of it. Presumably for driving diggers and other vehicles on to then pull them up and down the Thames and for whatever purposes they need. Looks like each of these boats probably has a bike up there, which makes sense if you just want to nip out into the local area. You don't want to take your whole boat. Just take your bike. Probably what you'd count as the entrance to the Grand Union. Well, I think it's called Brent Creek at this point. I was too busy looking at this goose. I didn't spot this one. Hello. There's a piece of art over there. I'm not sure we can get to it. We can't cross across here. Another little set of moorings. Oh, this is nice. It's a shoal of fish. And here's the Thames. It goes that direction into central London. And it goes that direction towards inland. And I think the next point we need to be is on that footpath directly opposite, because there's not really a footpath that runs along the edge of the river on this side. It ends up running round buildings and away from the actual edge of the canal. So we will hop over to that side and carry on from over there. Whew, that was fun. Must do that more often. I'll carry on this way. This over here is Royal Botanic Gardens at Kew. So there's a few greenhouses in among the trees over there, beyond the car park. Over here we have Kew Palace, as is usual with most large and public gardens in the UK. There was a stately home at the middle of them at one point. This one with a nice view out over the river. Well, it's probably quite a different view now than it was back when that was built. You've got a few of the big houses on barges over here, moored up on the edge of the Thames on the far side. We're not actually going as far as Hampton Court Palace. Hampton Court Palace is up the other way, or is it further on? I can't remember which. But on this loop, we are not going to pass Hampton Court. But I have considered we could do the Thames Path as a different video series at some point, and we would go past them then if we did that. Someone has decorated these trees for Christmas. Well, this is an interesting bit of wall. It looks like it could almost be a platform edge of a disused station, but I don't think it is. I think it's part of the flood defences where the natural level of the ground has dropped here. They've put this wall in to maintain a standard level of flood defence. If you ignore the hole in it, all along where the path level has dropped. This is the third one of these we've seen now. Just steps. We go down into the river. I guess they're probably useful if you need to moor up somewhere along here, but I'm not quite sure how you'd do that either. Okay, so this is Chiswick Bridge. It's starting to get dark again, as it does in winter. So we are going to end this walk here. We'll come back here. Actually, at time of recording now, we'll come back here after Christmas and carry on the walk under there along the Thames. But for now, we're going to end this one here. So we will head up here, up to the road, and we will see you again in the next video.